La description avec c'est. So let's start. So if you want to use this c'est option to make a description, so c'est technically would be directly translated as it is or this is, okay? But then in French, you will have to add after that the adjective, but the adjective should be all the time at the masculine form. Okay, so remember, if you want to describe something, okay, you can use this c'est, and that's really, you know, a common way to describe things. Okay, it is, this is, but then remember, the adjective that will come after should be at the masculine form. Okay, so we'll see a few examples now, and the first one would be the option to describe un lieu, a place. Okay, so let's see now. C'est chaud. Okay, it is hot. Warm, huh? Could be an option as well. C'est chaud, it's warm. Okay, c'est froid, cold. It is cold. C'est beau, beau is beautiful. Okay, and then c'est tranquille, quiet. Okay, so what you can see here is that we've got adjectives like chaud, froid, beau, and then tranquille. They are all at the masculine form. Okay, even if, I mean, the place would be feminine and you want to describe it, remember that it should be all the time at the masculine form. Okay, let's see another example. So if you want to describe a situation, for instance, okay, it would be an option. So, idéal, ideal, c'est idéal. Formidable. C'est parfait. So it's perfect. And then c'est injuste. Injuste, the opposite is of juste, okay? And it's not fair, unfair, okay? So c'est idéal, c'est formidable, c'est parfait, c'est injuste. Same thing here, okay, remember that all these adjectives are at the feminine form. Okay, let's continue now and see. So it could be for an object as well. You could describe an objet. So let's see now. C'est cher, cher is expensive, c'est cher. C'est utile, utile, useful. C'est beau, beautiful. C'est adapté. Adapted, okay? C'est cher, c'est utile, c'est beau, c'est adapté. Remember, all these adjectives are at the feminine, the masculine form. I'm getting tired now. All right, so at the masculine form, like I did say previously, okay? So let's see now another option. So if you want to describe a dish, okay, you're eating and you want to describe a dish, un plat, okay? So, c'est très bon, okay? Très is very, and then bon is good, okay? C'est très bon. C'est bon marché. Bon marché, it's actually quite interesting. I mean, this adjective here, so it's a composed adjective, and it means cheap, okay? C'est bon marché. C'est salé. So remember, it's quite important because we've got the same adjective here without the accent. So if you don't put the accent, it means dirty, and then you pronounce it sale. But in that case here, okay, you put the accent, and it's quite important because in that case it means salted, okay? Salé, okay? C'est salé. C'est délicieux. C'est délicieux, okay? And then same thing here, if you look all these adjectives, they are at the masculine form, okay? So the second option would be to put this structure at the negative form, which is not that difficult because technically you just keep, well, your structure, you just add as usual the first ne and then pas before and after the verb, okay? Then, same thing here, you will put this adjective at the masculine form, okay? So we will basically just see one more time all the examples we had previously, but then at the negative form. So if you want to describe a place, ce n'est pas chaud, ce n'est pas froid, ce n'est pas beau, ce n'est pas tranquille. Situation? Ce n'est pas idéal. Ce n'est pas formidable. Ce n'est pas parfait. Ce n'est pas injuste. An object? Ce n'est pas cher. Ce n'est pas utile. Ce n'est pas beau. Ce n'est pas adapté. And then a dish. Ce n'est pas très bon. Ce n'est pas bon marché. Ce n'est pas salé. Ce n'est pas délicieux.